Welcome back to another episode of Local Search Tuesdays. This week, I'm sharing marketing tips from the speakers at Digital Dealer and Driving Sales Executive Summit. I was in Vegas for an entire week since Driving Sales Executive Summit and Digital Dealer were back to back. And as always, I grabbed speakers and friends and had them share one awesome marketing tip. And I'm sharing them with you in this week's episode. So here we go.
If you're trying to create marketing for a dealership, think of it as if you're marketing to yourself. How do you want to be marketed to? Pro tip, don't market to somebody else, market to yourself. That's how people want to know what you're doing and how you're doing it.
All right, my tip to dealers is to stop blasting how great they are and doing everything sales related and transform into engaging with them via telling stories. And make sure that they want to do business with you without you having to push sales in their face, because then you make the whole relationship transactional instead of relationships. And if you can build a relationship by telling a story, you're going to have a lifelong customer rather than a customer that just buys a car from you and services it and you never see them again.
Here's my tidbit for dealers. Learn everything you can. Join Clubhouse, join Facebook forums, join Greg's podcast, follow everybody, learn what you can. Everything's changing so quickly, it's important to be in the know.
My tip for you is to leverage the third-party data that's available for the customers you're trying to target. If you reach out to, for example, Cars.com Social, Edmunds Ad Solutions, similar solutions, they have the real-time data of who is shopping for what you're selling in the area you're trying to target. Look at the cost of what that shopper is. It is up to 15 times cheaper than SEM. And it out-converts it and it converts more goals, much more engaged.
Owning your own first-party data and future-proofing your dealership against the cookie apocalypse is incredibly crucial right now.
So you can spend $1 million a month on all the nuances of paid search and lead generation and third-party acquisition of customer data, and it doesn't matter if you don't have processes and people in place to respond when the customer information reaches your CRM. Make sure you have a plan to prepare your people and have a strategy to convert those to car deals.
My tip for dealers is that competition is fierce right now, really fierce among dealers. Every lead counts. Even if you don't have a lot of staff, lean on technology that's available to you in the auto industry to not only respond to leads quickly, but also with a quality response that consumers crave. Not just answer their direct question, but also offer them other things in the response, like financing information, credit information, trade-in information, and maybe even offer the same car that they're inquiring about, and also maybe a different trim model or maybe a certified pre-owned model of the same kind of car that they're looking for. And you'll see your leads, your engagement increase tenfold. If you do it right, make every lead count.
So what I would say is go to one of the disruptors, CarMax, Carvana, Shift, Vroom, maybe even Tesla. Take a look at their websites and take a look at what they're doing these days, because they have a much, much, much better consumer experience. Then go to your dealership or any other dealership in your market and take a look at that website and ask yourself, truly, are you more likely to do business with that experience or the experience that the disruptors are giving? My point being is you can work with your provider right now and have a better experience, much cleaner, much more crisp, that'll convert better. That's my tip.
Okay, here's your SEO tip for the day. Make sure you understand what type of keywords your pages are ranking for. And what I mean by what type of keywords, I'm talking about either transactional keywords or informational keywords. Informational keywords may be something like how to program a Ford key fob, or a transactional keyword is going to be something along the lines of Ford Explorer lease, Ford Explorer price. Those are two different searches with two different intent and obviously two different outcomes. So make sure you know exactly what type of keywords you're using in your pages.
Tip of the day, Google Analytics isn't as easy as you think it is. And if you need help with it, you've got to go to the experts like Greg Gifford, like myself, to make sure that you're getting the right data in there, because again, just because it's free doesn't mean it's going to work for you.
Here in Vegas and just out of Colorado, 3 conferences in the last week, a lot of good marketing tips I've been given to the dealers. The one thing that drives me nuts with all these campaigns and ways to improve GMB and email marketing, all that, is UTM tracking. Remember to track every campaign, name it properly, and see what's working and not working. Don't get a bunch of direct links that you can't figure out which campaign it came from and is it working or not. A/B testing, UTM track everything and analyze.
All right, so here's your tip. We talk about it all the time and you are all still missing it. It's Google My Business. I have no idea why people are not looking at their Google My Business. I audited 10 dealerships while I was sitting at my booth here, and 9 of them had one category. One Ford dealer, Lincoln dealer, nothing. And you're wondering why you're missing and you're not showing up in search. Please go look at it. If you don't know how to do it, reach out to Greg, reach out to me. We are here to help you. You are missing out on opportunities. That's your tip.
A lot of people are talking about social media right now, but I think one of the things they're overlooking when they talk about Facebook Marketplace, instead of just going and trying to sell your wares on Facebook Marketplace, we have a lot of clients that are doing a great job reaching out to consumers that are selling their vehicles, private party, on Facebook Marketplace. We request their VINs for them. We run the information on their vehicle through Viotto, make appraisals, and we are buying dozens of cars every single month on behalf of our clients, assisting them, reaching out, communicating back and forth, and helping stock their lots with private party vehicles right from Facebook Marketplace. So make sure you're taking advantage of social media, not just to sell, but to acquire inventory.
All right, I was just gonna share a tip with you guys that we found out is if you're looking for technicians, which seems to be the biggest fixed ops obstacle that we have right now, make sure you don't send it to a landing page that has them fill out a form. A lot of technicians aren't on LinkedIn, they don't like filling out forms. So make sure if you're gonna do that and running Facebook campaigns, that it's either click to call or message the dealership. You'll get a lot more engagement that way.
That was awesome, wasn't it? Thanks for sticking with us to check them all out. That's all the time we've got for today, so you know what that means. Put your hand on the screen right here. We totally just high-fived because you learned something awesome. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next week for another episode of Local Search Tuesdays.